I think it's pretty crazy that there's a world out there that we get to experience. All we have to do is just go and see it. The timing doesn't have to be perfect, the people don't have to be perfect to go and see it with. But those moments with those people and the memories of the world, that's what sticks with you. I thought going on a trip like this would be something I always just dreamed about. I never thought it would actually happen. But one day I went from dreaming to planning. Planning the trip of a lifetime filled notebooks, files, and my TikTok-liked videos very quickly. We tried to go on this trip many times, and it never seemed to work out. After graduating high school, I didn't have enough money. 2 years ago, I had a family emergency. So after graduating college, there was never a more perfect time. To think that I get to go on this trip with some of my best friends before all moving separate directions and starting adult life makes it even sweeter. There's no time like the present. So 4 days after graduating college, we started on the trip of a lifetime. May 17th, 2022, we started the trip in a driveway in Atlanta, Georgia. Miles later, we made it to Memphis, Tennessee. And for lunch, we stopped at the crown jewel herself, Bass Pro Pyramid.
Some spam.
Oh, nothing but the best.
Look at the mac and cheese.
Yeah. We're eating good.
Life is good.
That's Bro is great.
That's Bro! Woo!
After our short stop in Memphis, it was time to get on the road to Arkansas. Woo!
Arkansas! Yeah!
So that's the Mississippi River, huh?
She's beautiful.
Me either.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Connor's family lives in Little Rock and they were nice enough to invite us in. And man, did I feel like I was in Arkansas. We sat on a back porch, ate hot dogs, drank Bush Light, and went on a paddle boat.
Arkansas!
Can we do this?
So what? I have...
Oh, I take this down there. I want to go film it. I'm working on it.
Oh my god.
Hey, it's overweighted,
that is
guys!
Awesome. That was some fat ass needs to get out of the back.
Arkansas, man.
After being immersed in Arkansas culture, we headed to the airport to pick up Connor.
Welcome to Little Rock!
The best car was now finally full. Now that everybody was here, we headed to get some custard and just hang out for the night.
Always get phone calls!
Tonight was one of the few nights we're gonna be staying in a hotel.
We were exhausted and happy to have a bed.
Will you get my thing and make sure you get it?
Like, look at
Little Rock kind of does suck. It is not it. Sorry, Little Rock.
Little Rock.
Lots of stealth.
Our caravan is not together.
What's up?
Where'd it go?
Steps that I take.
Little Rock, me too!
We are going to poop in Little Rock Sam's Club!
Dashing down the street, sitting in sunshine, private smoking weed, and sipping on Bob's wine. She knows me, but you called me by this name. Now she by the fire, hanging cold stockings, and letting baby Jesus do
we're
most of the talk.
There's beauty in
the
signs
that I chalk up to Christmas.
Today was a long haul day, but the car rides couldn't be more fun. After our long haul day, we made our way to the campsite. We were in the middle of nowhere, on Route 66 in Adrian, Texas. Pulling into the campsite, we were super excited for our first night of camping, but we were also a little uneasy with the storm brewing real close to us. It had finally set in that we were really out here. What do you think?
It kind of does.
It looks good.
My crib, we have like waterproof tents.
Yeah, we do.
Right.
Yeah. Perfect. Went on. And a storm brewing in the distance. It is ominous. But we got it. We're gonna be okay. Gonna be a
lightning strike detected within 1 mile.
It's totally hail. Dude, it's hailing.
Is it?
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah, you hear it?
Yeah.
Like
yeah,
a sign.
I think that is a severe thunderstorm.
Hail time.
Don't mean to dust it.
Hey.
No, we got it. Hey, welcome to our show, Out West.
Yep,
this is campsite number one.
Number one.
And a storm might be rolling in.
Hopefully it stays away.
But you know what? If it comes in, it might be fun. Might not be.
I would say might not be.
Ah, good one, Liberty.
The storm eventually passed and we were able to enjoy our first night of camping. Yeah, nice. We headed to bed and enjoyed the ambient sounds of Route 66 all night.
Today was our last long haul day, and we watched the state signs roll by. Of course, we had to stop at most of them.
I'm half awake most of the time, it's just the timing of the seasons. So you know I worry at your home.
We're going to the Petrified Forest.
After the disappointment of the Petrified Forest, we headed to our campsite. The sunset on the drive there made up for every ounce of the Petrified Forest. It might have been one of the most beautiful sunsets I've ever seen.
Just in a minute, once we get situated.
When we got to camp, we set up real quick and just enjoyed the views.
We're just out here.
We're making some
living
food.
Living life. We got ramen. The greatest.
Oh, yummy, yummy. What's going on?
You found some actual. No.
Poop? Human? Hey, what's up? Steve.
What's up?
What's going on?
Not much.
We camping out here. We really out here. I love Camp Louisa. Camp Louisa's the best.
I am the best.
Yes. Yeah. Lucy? You're not wearing a shirt.
I know, I got hot.
What?
Drink a little pina colada.
This is a cruise ship. Yeah, sure, dude.
Welcome to my bar.
What in the world? Am I in Hawaii?
Yes.
What are you guys? What are you serving up, dude?
Sure. So we have some coconut rum mixed with orange juice, pina colada juice, and Sprite.
Okay, I'll take one. I'll take
it's
one.
Really good.
Thank you. Wow, I feel like I just got transported to the cruise, Louisa. Hi, Connor.
Hi.
What's up?
Not much, just unloading.
Camping out, unloading. Hey, Austin.
Hey.
This cool drawer system you got, Ashlyn. Hey. You're working hard over here.
Party is starting.
Yes, ma'am.
So far, the trip felt like it'd been leading up to this day. There was finally a reward for the hundreds of miles we had driven. When we were planning this trip, we always looked forward to the Grand Canyon and couldn't believe that we'd be standing there in a few short months. And the day was finally here. That reward was getting to see the Grand Canyon.
Bye-bye.
Danger, danger. Hey!
Donut? What? Eating a donut.
Me?
I am.
Ooh, yummy. 2, 1, go. Ooh.
3, 2, 1, 8. Ooh. Alright, Connor, you go.
Wait, who am I going against?
Go against Sophie.
Alright. 110. Mm-hmm. Okay.
3, 2, 1.
2.
Ah, dang. The lottery ticket.
Haley, are you excited? You've already been here.
I'm so excited. I think I'm really gonna get to be able to see everything in this content, you know?
Ready?
Oh yeah.
You ever been here before?
Yeah, last time I was here it was snowing.
Oh whoa. Are you ready? Have you ever seen the Grand Canyon?
I've never seen the Grand Canyon.
Oh my goodness.
So fun.
Hey, are you ready?
I'm really ready.
Do you think you're gonna be, your jaw is gonna drop? Or you think you're just...
No, I don't know if it'll drop.
Hopefully you don't drop.
Yeah.
You go to the bathroom?
I did. Oh! Wait, we're crazy. Oh my god.
Okay, we're about
about to look at the Grand Canyon for the first real time.
Oh my god.
Holy freak.
This is insane.
Dude, I am terrified
it's
right
crazy.
Now.
It's crazy. Hate it so.
I know.
We did it, dude.
Grand Canyon. Oh my god.
Wow. Woo-hoo. It's really windy. We keep losing our hats. Dude, look at this. Look at this.
During this moment, I was fully present, taking in the breathtaking views of the Grand Canyon. And being beside some of my best friends was unlike anything I've ever experienced. To think this was one of our first real spots made me so excited for the days to come. After leaving the Grand Canyon, we headed to our campsite at the Vermilion Cliffs. This drive was incredible. We were surrounded by cliffs in the middle of nowhere, hanging out the windows, yelling at the top of our lungs. The vibes were off the chart. The air was cool and you could feel the wind whipping past you. We're so excited for the night ahead of us. Pulling into the campsite was unbelievable. We couldn't believe that we got to spend the night here. Point in the trip, we felt like we had the camping thing down. We'd get to a campsite and immediately start setting up the tents, and we all had our own little jobs to do. But man, this campsite was breathtaking. I found myself just sitting back and enjoying the time with my friends. We laughed a lot this night. When we woke up this morning at the Vermilion Cliffs, something just felt off. We all had an unsettling feeling in our stomach, and we weren't sure why. We woke up to some of the boys missing after deciding to go on an early morning hike. They eventually returned and said we had to go on this hike later. So we continued on with our morning, just like normal.
Dude, look where we're at. What in the world? We slept here last night.
Cinnamon latte.
Wow, this is crazy.
We love it.
After packing up the campsite, we decided to go for the morning hike that the boys recommended. We headed to the unmarked trail and began hiking. Soon after starting the hike, Louisa began to lose her footing. She started to fall feet overhead towards a massive drop-off.
A rock was the only thing that stopped her. I remember seeing the boys chase after her and running to find a first aid kit. And the rest was just a blur.
Not knowing the full severity of Louisa's injuries, we decided to go to the hospital. The closest one was over an hour away. The drive to the hospital felt like it took forever. We were winding through back roads and through cliffs, and trying to keep Louisa as comfortable as possible.
We arrived at the hospital in Page, Arizona. At this point, we gave Louisa enough Tylenol where she was able to walk in, but she was still in a lot of pain. After she had a thorough assessment, her hand was the only thing that had major damage. And after painful 10 stitches, she was cleared to go. This was a wake-up call, and we were so thankful she was okay. Everyone was sitting tailgating in the parking lot waiting for her to come out. This really bonded everyone together and gave us a much-needed wake-up call. It could have been so much worse. And Louisa was able to rally. We were able to continue our journey, and by 2 p.m. that day, we were at Antelope Canyon. Antelope Canyon felt like one of the most special places on Earth. You couldn't begin to see them from above, and then you're climbing down massive ladders into one of the most beautiful canyons. It was one of the first things that genuinely took my breath away. And I think it did for a lot of us.
recording.
What's up?
What's up, Connor?
Look at the bar now.
We're at Horseshoe Bend.
Whoa. We're at Horseshoe Bend. Yeehaw.
Yeehaw. Where's the horses?
We're at horses. Cal's on my side.
We then made our way up to Horseshoe Bend. At this point, we were all so tired from the crazy day we've had, but we were ready to see one of the most beautiful sights.
Stay out of the camera.
It's the survivor.
Survivor!
I don't know how to turn this off.
That's crazy.
Oh, I mean, have you seen the light guy on the commercial lake in Georgia?
Oh my god.
Today was emotionally and physically exhausting. But we were so thankful that everyone was okay and we were able to continue on this trip.
Hearts worth falling for. Oh, and with open arms, I'll carry yours. Come.
The two-wheel drive couldn't do it.
Rain or shine, come. Rain or shine, I'll cover you up.
Welcome to Lone Rock Beach.
What's up?
Hey.
The runner down here.
Look at the runner.
Look at the runner. Hey.
You are mine.
See?
I'll be there when you
need
me.
So cool.
You can count on it. Just as sure as the sun will rise, I'll be there when you need me. With every tear that falls from your eyes, oh, you have me completely. I'll be there when you, I'll be there when you need me.
Look at this freaking view. It's crazy. And we're stuck again.
How are we sleeping here?
What?
We're just going anywhere to sleep in there.
We are, honestly, at this point. Oh! Whoa.
Yeah.
Dinner is served. Wow, thank you.
Y'all want to have a picnic on the blanket?
Look at these folks. Look at these folks.
Don't underestimate.
Louisa, don't worry.
What?
We won't underestimate.
Everyone does underestimate me.
No, we don't. Not after today.
So I know she was the favorite.
Steven, that was silly.
No, I learned. It was a lot for me. Good night, guys.
We woke up this morning and took baths in the lake. It was nice to feel clean and have some fresh hair. As you can tell, I'm feeling myself here.
Hey, Louisa!
Hey!
How's our survivor doing?
Good. This is the thing to do now.
Ice.
All the cool tips.
Keep that inflammation down, right?
Yeah.
Glad you're alive.
So.
Hey, Megan.
How you doing?
Good. I didn't sleep too well.
Oh, really? I felt like tonight was a better night's sleep.
Oh.
We finally showered.
Yay! See, what's up?
Howdy.
Howdy.
How you feeling?
I feel good, man.
I'm feeling great.
Look at this drawer system, though. Hey, Ashlyn. Oh,
bounce.
Look my nose.
Whoa, let's get an action shot.
Okay, ready?
Ready. Woo! What you doing?
This is the opening of my edit.
Okay, ready? I'm gonna do a big. Little close up action. Drove down. What? Dude.
After our day at Zion, we headed to the campsite for the night.
And all my fears are facts of life, but I could die tomorrow. You be close.
We never know how truly sweet a moment is until we've already experienced it. Sitting at this campsite tonight has made me so thankful for the moments we've gotten to live on this trip. So thankful for the people and the world that we get to experience. Being surrounded by my friends, laughing, and looking at one of the most gorgeous views had me captivated the whole night.
Hey, Louisa. Louisa, this song.
The thing I love most about camping is it feels like a reset. All you have to worry about is setting up your bed, figuring out dinner, and drinking enough water. The rest is all about good times.
Haley!
Please,
please, please, please. I'm gonna take a drink.
She's almost gone. I got Lucy's pepper. Lucy
got the pepper. Dude, what?
Are you taking that, homie?
How is that?
What is the box?
It is. Okay. It's clouding my mind now.
Look at that.
Cheers. 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 Cheers.
Cheers.
You feel better?
What are you doing here?
I'm trying to find a hat to get rid of these dang bugs.
Oh, man.
Oh.
Whoa, look at that view.
Our dump truck.
That dump truck.
Did I show you the picture?
Yes.
Look at Louise.
You look like the old woman
walking. Survivor.
I thought
that was the marketing campaign. Putting so much time into planning this trip, and now finally getting to live these moments with these people, just has me feeling so full.
Close behind.
Ashlyn, where are we at? What are we about to do?
Go swimming.
Go swimming. Austin, hey.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning. Hi, guys. How are we doing?
Could you mind also tape
yeah,
it down?
Yeah, for sure.
I don't have tape on this.
Look at these battles.
I'm tough. Tough girl.
What are we doing? What are we doing? What are we doing?
You know, we got some coffee.
Mm-hmm.
We're ready to go hike.
Yes, ma'am.
Look at this crew. You look like Moses.
I am.
Oh,
That's probably cultural appropriation. Okay.
Something.
The narrow. Here we go.
Road less traveled.
We got Louise on our leash.
Outside, pee outside.
Yeah, we're really living our full human potential here.
It's a day to be tall.
It's an awful day to be short. Woo! That was good.
Yeah, I want to go get in that hot tub literally right now.
Right now.
I literally have my swimsuit on. I'm ready.
No.
We can't get in the hot tub. Yeah, throw it good.
Yeah.
We'll see if it works.
If it doesn't work,
yes, we got it. Wow. We got it. Hot tub time. Welcome to the salt flats. Isn't this place crazy?
After 2 days of recuperating in Utah, it was time to continue on the road. Our drive to Arches was long today, so it was filled with a lot of murder podcasts.
In a very long and painful journey, we ask that you keep us in your...
Nice.
Yummy.
This will be my hand model hand.
I'm gonna see it getting.
Whoa, for comparison. Wait, can we see a bad throat?
Yeah, let me show you my black gum.
Yeah, let's see it. All our injuries.
Sophie is going to say cut on the trap.
Yeah, Steven wants that.
Steven's been trying since day one.
Yeah,
and I demolished him.
You demolished yourself,
to be the
too.
Sick cut on the trap.
Look.
I genuinely
Look, don't spoil Moab for me.
Oh, yeah.
The scenery.
No, this one.
Wow.
Haley, I genuinely thought you took this out and was reading this one.
Liberty.
No, I have my own.
Hey, Cav. National Park. Check out the boards.
Oh,
Cav, you about to bomb the hill?
For Connor.
Yes! Sandboarder out here. She's doing her little bindings.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. Oh.
On this trip, dreams became blurred with reality, and it made every day feel like a dream, but I actually got to live it and feel it. I'll remember the way my friends laughed sitting in the middle of nowhere about who knows what, or the way looking at the Grand Canyon for the first time made me feel. In my
darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, oh, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be.
Want to see something fun?
Yeah.
No.
What?
Show my butt.
Your butt?
Yeah.
People living in.
I think if there's one thing to take away from this trip, is that all moments eventually pass us. But if we can just be present in these moments, it'll make us so thankful and remember them forever. I'll do exactly that with this trip out west.
There is still a chance that they may see. There will be an answer.
Tonight was a picture-perfect ending to one of the best trips ever.
Let it be.
Let it be.
Like, hand out the MVP award to Connor.
To think that I dreamed of this trip since high school, and now I get to watch these moments become memories. For not only me, but for my friends. These are the stories that they're gonna tell their kids one day. And that's just the best feeling.
From my true time.